Intently studying Sutherland's approach to pipeline was a young surfer from Honolulu named Gerry Lopez.
When I first tried surfing the pipeline, it was back in 63 or so. I think I was a sophomore in high school. I don't think I made one single drop. Jock paddled out, watching us flounder. He gave us some tips, and he told me, when you take off, angle a little on the takeoff. And that was like really a breakthrough tip.
Lopez took Sutherland's advice, returning to his home break of Ala Moana on the South Shore to hone his tube riding technique.
He was a town kid and went to high school, Punahou, and so Ala Moana was kind of his breeding ground.
What he did is he developed a downrailed surfboard with a tucked under edge that allowed him to ride higher and tighter in the curl, which was a big deal. At the same time, he developed a style on that board where he sort of would drop in and turn in the middle of the face where before he couldn't on the softer rail board, and he would drive right through the center of the tube and come out. And so with those two innovations, he really could start getting his pipeline act together.
Few could have predicted that this surfer riding this wave would change the entire direction of the sport, establishing what the collective surfing world would come to consider the ultimate ride.
Gerry was very smooth and very casual. Ironically, by other standards, he was considered kind of a little too slow and a little too smooth. And coming out here to Pipeline, where everybody else was like holding on and just trying to make the wave, all of a sudden, here's this guy who takes off and very casually, nonchalantly pulls into the barrel, completely disappears, comes out, and just kind of...
He wasn't like torqued out with veins popping out. He'd just slump and do this casual bottom turn and then stand there like a bullfighter and get pitted and then spit out and then just do the zen and go floating out under the shoulders. Paddled out and the peak at pipe was his. So he got to pick and choose and analyze and had an understanding of the wave that is pretty hard to do nowadays.
You could never overpower pipeline. So what Gerry figured out is that it was going to take something more than power or even more than performance. It was going to take emotion.
One time I really felt like I was really close to it and I really had some kind of spiritual relationship going with the place. Waves would come to me where I didn't really have to do anything. They would just come to me and they would be real easy to catch.
You go, oh my God, look at his knowledge. He picks the right wave every time. Nowadays, you go shoot photos, and there's so-and-so's out, so-and-so. You can just set up and start shooting, because there's so many surf stars now. In those days, the show was Gerry.
He was pipeline, okay? When he took off on a wave, he became the wave.
One day, I said, do you practice in front of a mirror doing your thing?
It wasn't so much that he did unbelievable maneuvers, it was just that what he did was just so beautiful.
Gerry was an artist, and his canvas was the pipeline, and he was by far and away the best at riding those waves, and that was his genius.
I reached a level of understanding with the wave to where suddenly, instead of becoming an adversarial kind of relationship, it was something that was really friendly.
And he always put his hand up the top of the wave and tickle his hand up in the side of the wave like that, you know?
He stroked her cheek. There was foreplay involved, and so she opened up.
I don't know. She was nasty at times, but she was so beautiful.